Hey everyone, I'm Tammy from SketchUp for Interior Designers, and today I want to talk to you about link sharing. More specifically, what to do with a link that has been given to you so that you can look at a 3D model. How do you navigate this model? How do you see the information that is set up for you from whoever built this model? Let's talk about the most important buttons and panels right now. You can load the model simply by copying and pasting the link into your browser address here. And once it loads, you should see something like this. Yours will look different because you're looking at a different model. But right away, you can see my cursor has changed to a different icon. This is the orbit tool. So if I were to click and drag upwards, you can see and downwards that my model is orbiting. I'm orbiting around the view of my model. So actually the model is staying in the same place. We're just changing the camera view of it. So practice clicking and dragging from side to side, up and down. So that's the orbit tool. Now the pan tool is going to be this hand here. And if you hover over it, you can see pan. There's also a shortcut, letter H here. I can click and drag side to side, up and down. So this one is as though we have a piece of paper and we're just moving it side to side, up and down. So we can use this in conjunction with the orbit tool. So if you'd like to orbit to view it from here, and then if you get a little bit too low, you can switch over to your pan tool to scoot the drawing upwards. Again, the drawing itself, the model itself is staying right where it's at. We're just changing the camera view of it. So that is our pan tool. Here we've got our zoom, click and drag inward and outward. Now, I don't necessarily like to use this zoom tool for zooming function because it only zooms in on center of the screen. I can't zoom in on something over here. It's just as though it were on a truck moving straight forward and straight back. Instead, I like to use either my center scroll wheel of my mouse to roll forward and backward, or my trackpad, which I'm using right now. So if I go back to say the orbit tool here, or any other tool really, I can hover over something in my model, like say this light fixture, and then do two fingers towards me or that center scroll wheel. You can practice scrolling it forward and backwards to choose what you are zooming in on. So whatever your cursor is over, that is going to be your zoom point. So you can see here over these leaves, and as I zoom in, swiping towards myself, that is going to be the point of zoom. So this guy here, not as helpful, but helpful for zooming straight in and out in a hurry. And then right below that, we have zoom extents, which will bring us all the way out to see everything that is in our drawing. So if this was a large drawing, I would zoom way out and see a lot more, but just to the extents of the model. So if you happen to get lost in a wall like this, you can click on zoom extents to pop yourself right back out. Now those are the main viewing tools. I wouldn't worry too much about these right now. Next up, let's talk about the panels on the right. The one that I would focus on is this little action icon here. That is going to be your scenes. And that's important because the person who created this probably created some scenes for you to toggle through. So if I click on my scenes, you can see the dropdown with a few thumbnails. I set myself up with this file. So I have three views. I've got my plan view, top view in 3D, and an elevation view. So let's click on that first one, and that brings me right into an interior perspective. So I created this file. So if I was sharing it with somebody, I would set up a scene to get them in the exact camera location that I would like so they can view their model. And here again, we've got that orbit. In this case, zooming in and out and maybe panning might be more helpful. I don't want to orbit myself right back outside. So go back to my scenes here, click on view one to get back to a good spot. View two, again, I set up this file, but whoever set this file up for you hopefully set up some scenes to show you what they are trying to get you to look at. Then we've got our floor plan, top view in 3D, and an elevation view. All right, you may notice that these last three are in parentheses, and that just means they are going to be excluded from an animation. And to find the animation, you can go up to here, this icon, the little TV screen with the play, and then click play down here, and it will toggle through those three scenes that were not excluded from the animation. So it's loading up. You can see that was that view one, view two. It halts for a moment to let you see it, and then it'll go right back. So this is really helpful for large homes or large spaces where you can really walk through the house in these preset scenes. So make sure you kind of look to the top for that animation view. And then to stop this, of course, we can press pause or click on this X up here. Now, if you are playing this and this panel is in your way, you can click on this square here to collapse that view. And I should have pressed play here before I did that. Let's press play and then hover over that. So it collapses the view so that we can see more of what we're looking at without having all the panels in the way. If we want to bring those panels back, we can simply hover over the bottom here and click on that same area icon to exit that full screen. Now I can click on the X to get rid of that and return back to the panel that I was looking at before. And that is really what you should focus on, is looking for those scenes that somebody has set up for you. If they haven't set them up, you may need to kind of navigate yourself using the panel on the left, those navigation tools. But if you have received a link, maybe ask the person, you know, you got some scenes set up for me, because this is really what you're going to be looking for. And before we end this video, I do want to point out that you have the ability currently to measure things. So if I go to my floor plan, you can see this little measuring tape here. I can click on one edge or endpoint and click on another one, or just hover, and you can see that measurement appearing for me. Now, if you want to start again, maybe you clicked on the wrong spot, you can hit escape to let go of that starting point and then start over with a new one. So here we go, straight from here to here, we've got 12 foot 10 and some change. Again, if I want to let go of that, I can hit escape to start in a new area. That's the measurement tool, really handy when you want to get to know your floor plan or your space in 3D a little bit better. And that's it. I know there's more buttons, but those are really the most important buttons to focus on, that scenes panel. Now, this is a relatively new product from SketchUp, so it may look different than it does now at time of recording, so don't come at me if the panels look massively different when you start using it. I know that they're going to continue to improve and listen to feedback on this new feature. I hope that was helpful.